In the discriminant-based approach to classification, the discriminant functions are chosen so that the error on our dataset X with parameters W is minimized. So we are always looking to choose parameters W in such a way that we reach this minimum of this error function of W given the sample X. Now, if the error function is chosen so that it's a differentiable function, we can apply an iterative optimization approach based on the partial derivatives of these error functions. And that's the reason why very often as an error function, we choose something like the mean square, which is differentiable everywhere. So in that case where you have everywhere differentiable error function, you can think about this gradient vector, and that's the vector collecting all these partial derivatives of the error function with respect to the components of our parameter vector W. So you have DE to DW1 and DE to DW2 and so on all the way to DWD. Now, the significance of this gradient is that is going to help us to drive the iterative procedure for achieving the minimum of this function. And this is how it's done. We would start from some random initial value W, and then we are going to update W iteratively in the negative direction of this gradient. And I want to open this up a little bit to you in a visual way, so you see what's the significance of this, advancing step by step the value of W. So here is a slope for our error function. It could be anything, but for example, this one. And if we think about this point here, the error in this point W, if our error function is like this, this is a descending slope, so the partial derivative of the error with respect to W at this point is going to be negative because it's a descending slope. And advancing it with a value proportional to this to the value of the derivative and in the direction inverse to the sign of this derivative is going to mean in practice that you are going to advance the value of WT to a point more to the right. You are going to increase the value because the derivative has a negative sign. And you are going to increase it with a value that's proportional to the value of this partial derivative or the slope of the function on this point W. If you think about another point, for example, here on an ascending slope, because the partial derivative is positive here, this is going to imply that you are going to have a smaller value for W in the next step, which means that you will have a W that is going to bring you, to the left of your plot here. So kind of one step closer to hopefully reaching this minimum. So in general, we are going to advance the value of each one of these parameters with delta WI, which is minus DE to DWI times a parameter eta. And I'm going to discuss this in just a moment. And then you are advancing the value of W, and you are setting it to whatever it was before plus this delta of WI. And the way this would go would be like this. If you start from this value, you are going to push it first here because you have this negative partial derivative, and that's going to imply increasing the value of your W, and then maybe you are increasing it a little bit more, and then maybe you increase it, and by increasing it, it so happens that you skip the minimum. But here because you have an ascending slope, that's going to push a decrease in the value of W, and then maybe you are on this part of the slope, and that's going to push an increase of the value of W. And because the derivatives are smaller and smaller as you are closer to this minimum, hopefully that's going to imply that these jumps are smaller and smaller because they are proportional to the value of the derivative. So intuitively speaking, this should be a good way of pushing the value of your parameters so that you reach this this minimum here. There are a few points I want to make about this, and one is that obviously this is a numerical procedure that doesn't really guarantee reaching the global minimum. In this example that I showed here visually, you might approach this minimum, but in fact it's just a local minimum. The global minimum could be somewhere totally different, but this procedure might not allow you to reach that value unless you started from an initial value of W somewhere else, maybe closer to this global minimum. So that's one point to make. There is no guarantee that you are reaching the global minimum. And also in connection to this, the procedure is sensitive to the initial value of the parameter that you choose. The other point I want to make is that this parameter eta is really important because that's going to give you a measure of this step you are making in increasing, step by step, the value of W. And the point here is that this eta, which by the way, eta is called, so eta is called the step size or learning factor. The point here is that if you choose a learning factor that's too small, this is going to be a procedure that converges very slowly, and so you might need a long time to reach the global minimum. On the other hand, if you take a learning factor that's too large, that's going to imply oscillations in your procedure, and maybe even is going to to lead to a diverging procedure. So there is a balance here that you have to achieve with this learning factor, and this depends on the shape of this error function, which is not directly known to you. So that implies a number of attempts you could do at learning the minimum of these error functions with different values of eta. One more point I want to make is that gradient descent is not the only way to solve numerically this minimization problem for the error function. We only discuss about the gradient descent because it's powerful enough in practice, and it's certainly simple enough. But there are also other methods, some of which are specifically designed to help you find the global minimum. Others that are more sophisticated and take more aspects of this error function into account. For example, they could be a second order or third order procedures. And so there are other methods such as simulated annealing, genetic algorithms, and other methods that we don't discuss in this course, but it's good to keep in mind that such more sophisticated methods do exist.